There's a chest here.
Wow. This place is huge.
Okay.
Emerge right now, right here. Absorption test.
Bouncy mushrooms and domains. Okay, do these work the same way? I guess not. Okay, there's like... Okay, what the fuck? There's like different ways to go here. Hello? So this is a new type of domain then, I guess. More! Shit, that's not what I wanted to do. Where am I going? I've turned into a little fairy. I feel like I must have missed something. You will sometimes find these sealed paths that correspond to the... Okay, so collect three of these things to unlock the pathway. Love that green water. Wait, how do I get up there? Oh. Okay, so we're back in here. Oh, there's a chest over there. I guess that's maybe the doorway we need to open, so I have to find the other ways we didn't go. Is this one that I've done? Okay, that's the one that I think we were just in. What? What? Now we're in Inazuma. I don't know what the fuck's going on. Shit, I think I fucked that. Dude! Wait. Okay. No! Okay. Don't fuck me. Okay, we got a locked door. Okay, there's symbols on the rocks. Can I interact with this? No. Oh, I see. You want to match up the thing. Okay. That's awful. That just totally made my eyeballs stop working for a second. This place is gorgeous, though. Very, very unique compared to where all the other places we've been in the game so far. Which, if they keep that up with each region, that's pretty impressive.
Well. Looks like we meet again, traveler.
What the hell? I'm afraid they do. No, I don't want to fight this guy.
Right here. Right now. Right here. Jumpy, jumpy, jump! Stand clear.
Fuck my butt.
Allow me. Absorption test. Cut. Emerge. Don't break my glasses.
Ow!
Really hurt! Right now, emerge, right here. Nothing lasts forever.
I didn't do anything to it.
La la la.
Dude! Okay, that's why I didn't do anything, because it's...
Huh?
It's scripted.
Why can't we beat this guy? Oh, Paimon doesn't get it! We faced others like him before! What's wrong this time?
Plot. Armor.
Though you may have managed to avert countless crises before, your good fortune was bound to end sooner or later. It's time you realize how weak and powerless you really are. Your brother. Or are you just living in complete denial? His Highness has long since forsaken you. Your meager existence in his eyes is that of an annoying bug, only to be stepped upon. The bonds of love and family which drive you to find your sibling are utterly gone. Your journey is meaningless. But don't you fret now. Today will be your last. Now die!
No, I don't think I will. There's food around her now.
What do we do? We haven't seen Hypatia anywhere out here.
What?
Oh, there she is! Quick, let's see how she's doing.
I know she said it was like a dream, but...
So sweet.
Well, the good news is that she's still conscious. Hey, why'd you drop her food on the floor like that? Are you okay? That's really not like you. Anyways, we can talk about this later. We better make sure she's all right first. Whoa, wait a sec. Look at all this fruit lying around her. We can put that to good use.
Who is there? Tainari, is that you?
It's okay. You can relax, Hypatia. Tainari sent us here to bring you some food and water. Here, we have a letter that he asked us to give you.
Oh no, my arms hurt.
I see. So, you're friends of Tainari. I apologize for all the trouble I've caused you. I'm grateful that you came so quickly to save me. You even brought all this fruit.
Well, actually, we didn't bring the fruit. It was already here when we arrived. We were kind of wondering about that, actually. When we found you here, there was all this fruit lying around and even some juice dripping from your lips. How did you end up like this anyway?
Oh, really? I seem to understand now. All the fruit was likely from my, neighbor. Must have come by and saw me like this.
Your neighbor? You mean there's someone else living nearby?
Is it a little round creature? Kind of like a cabbage?
Oh? So you're able to see them too?
Wait, hold on a second, traveler. You say that before we arrive, you saw some mysterious creature and suddenly had a strange dream? Isn't that a little too crazy to believe?
No, I actually do believe what the traveler is saying. I myself had a similar experience once before and ended up scaring my timid little neighbor here. You needn't worry. They mean you no harm. They only dragged you into the dream because they hoped to buy themselves a little time in order to scurry away.
So, Hypatia, just what kind of creature is your neighbor exactly?
I'm not sure what it's called, to be honest. But I do know that they have some sort of deeper connection with the Dendro Archon. I know this because the first time I saw them was also the exact day my consciousness was able to form a connection with Ermin's soul. Even after I opened my eyes and stopped meditating, my heart was still pounding. And my mind was racing with all the knowledge that I had touched. And at that very moment, I suddenly noticed a small figure at the opening of the cave. In my curiosity, I began to walk over to the creature. They must have already been used to me living in the cave, because they didn't seem to mind me approaching them. They just kept doing whatever they were up to. It wasn't until I crouched down next to them that they suddenly realized that I could see them.
Oh! And then?
And then I had a dream. By the time I came to, they were nowhere to be seen. I was convinced they'd never show up again. But sure enough, I saw them nearby a few days later. And they weren't alone.
Oh, God.
I feel like they aren't as afraid of me as the first time I approached them. But I never would have expected them to save me. Yes, no doubt about that. By the way, Tainari mentioned in his letter that you had questions for me regarding Ermansoul. Sorry about that. Sounds like just drinking juice still isn't quite enough for my stomach.
Well, if somebody hadn't dropped the food earlier... Anyway, looks like we'll need to prepare something ourselves. Besides, Paimon's getting hungry too. Let's eat first and talk about Ermansoul later.
Let's go do the event.
We're up, Traveler. Today's menu will feature Sweet Madame and a radish veggie soup. You'll love them, Hypatia. They're our specialties after all.
Sounds good. I've never tried any dishes from other nations before. I certainly look forward to it. It's been so long since I've had a decent meal, too. To be honest, the last time had to be when Tainari came to visit.
Make some food by the fireside. Where? Wait, why can't I touch this thing? See, I saw this earlier. That's why I walked over here. But then suddenly I could... I guess it was a potato.
You cook up some dishes over the fire.
All done! Let's use the empty box that Tainari gave us since we already washed it. Oh, it smells amazing! And the box is a nice touch, too! Let's go serve this up and start eating with Hypatia!
Are you already finished cooking? Smells delectable! I'm truly thankful whenever I can enjoy a proper meal like this. Cooking really isn't my forte. Even though everything you mentioned was in Tainari's letter, it's still hard to believe you were able to connect with Ermansoul immediately after smelling spirit-borne eel for the first time. It took me nearly 3 years before I could do so. And everyone at the academia even lauded me as a genius. You should know that some researchers spent their entire lives without ever successfully connecting with Ermansoul as you have.
So why does this incense allow people to connect to Ermansoul?
The ingredients used to make spirit-borne ale primarily consist of plants created by Greater Lord Ruka Devata. These special ingredients are conducive to heightening our senses to the Dendro Archon's power. Since the root of the Dendro Archon's power lies within Ermansoul, we can occasionally tap into her powers to peer into the depths of the Earth. Naturally, anyone who can establish a connection with Ermansoul in their first ever attempt must be a person of great understanding.
Makes sense. But Paimon's got a question. Why was she sensitive to the smell of those plants for such a long time?
That was primarily due to her body's unique constitution. Stimulated by the incense, she could perceive the Dendro Archon's power and experience the sensory overload, hence the adverse reactions. Taking in any scent similar to the ingredients of spirit-borne ale would cause adverse effects. Not to worry, though. It appears you've already fully recovered. Technically, your body should still be sensitive to the powers of the Dendro Archon, But unless you're using intentional meditation techniques, the scent of spirit-borne ale should no longer trigger such reactions.
Whew. Well, that's a relief.
I must admit, I am quite envious of your abilities. Even if it meant suffering from pounding headaches for the rest of my life, I'd consider it worthwhile so long as I could connect with Irminsul at will.
Whoa, you're really serious about this whole thing, aren't you?
I am a researcher, after all. As a member of the Ritawis Darshan at the Academia, my main area of research is the stars and their connection to the fate of living beings. But there is still so much we don't know, especially regarding the mysteries that lie in the starry skies. Which is why I must turn to the all-knowing Irminsul for answers. If only my perception wasn't so limited! Unfortunately, I cannot guarantee that my every attempt to attune with Irminsul will be successful, or that doing so will leave my consciousness intact. I am currently in the stage of training known as Satyavada Life. Many researchers in Sumeru have lost their minds while seeking to attune with Irminsul during this stage. Sages have said that Irminsul contains divine knowledge, and touching such knowledge without the proper preparations and abilities will only lead to one's mind caving in on itself. That's why we meditate alone. We need to ensure that our minds will be calm, while minimizing the possibility of involving anyone else.
Whoa! So knowledge from Irminsul can be super dangerous! Aren't you afraid of the risk, Hapeja?
Of course I do. Especially during nights that are pitch black with no moonlight, and dead silent without even the sound of insects. However, I've been feeling better as of late. I don't get as scared anymore knowing that I have a little neighbor living nearby. I believe that being able to see them is a sort of blessing from the Dendro Archon. But what's strangest of all is that they're clearly an envoy of the God of Wisdom herself. And they have the curious power to make people dream.
What's so strange about that? It doesn't sound so out of place for a divine being, does it?
Well, it's strange because nearly nobody in Sumeru can ever dream.
What?
Is that true?
Yes. Well, to an extent. Only children can dream in Sumeru.
What?
Adults, however, never do.
What?
The sages say that wisdom implies rationality, but that which occurs in dreams is often neither rational nor logical. Yes, if one struggles with anxieties, those emotions could influence their dreams. The fact that the people of Sumeru do not have dreams is seen as a blessing by the sages. They believe that Greater Lord Rukadevata, the God of Wisdom, is keeping us away from the foolish delusions you encounter in your sleep. I was born into a family of scholars in Sumeru City. Ever since I was a child, my parents would always tell me that I'll know I've grown up once I stop dreaming. I studied hard, enrolled as a student in the Academia, and went on to become a researcher. Sure enough, I never dreamed again. But then, on the day I scared the little Aranara, I suddenly saw a dream again. It was incredible. Though I don't exactly remember what I saw, I clearly recall the feeling. I suddenly felt like I was a child again. Back then, I was foolish and ignorant as any youth would be, but I was free of fear. Maybe dreaming isn't as bad as we've made it out to be. Just be sure not to speak of this if you travel to Sumeru City. They'll look at you as if you've lost your mind.
So, do you have any thoughts about the things she saw when she connected with Irminsul?
Sorry. I'm afraid I don't have any answers as of now. All I can say is that what you saw is a memory contained within Irminsul itself. World forget me. What could that possibly mean? If only I could ascend past Satyavada life and begin Paripurna life. I might have some more answers for you. If you two are ever in the area again, please be sure to come and see me. There's no need to be thanking me. You two are my saviors. Besides, I'm already looking forward to tasting some more of your cooking.
Oh, something shot out of my ass. My nose.
Now that we know Hypatia is alright and had the chance to ask her some questions, Paimon thinks it's about time to head back to Gundarvaville.
Yeah, no shit. No, nothing against the Sumeru storyline, but I don't know what the fuck this has to do with Kale. Besides the fact she's in bed. I'm gonna cheat a little bit. Got a green oculi. Aha! Dendroculus. Dendroculus.
Think about it, Tainari. Refusing to join is tantamount to burying your head in the sand. I understand that you're a forest watcher and that it's your duty to combat the effects of withering zones. But isn't it evident that such work is not a lasting solution to the problem? As Sage Kage clearly stated, your presence and guidance in Sumeru City is pivotal in finding a cure for Ermansul. How could you possibly refuse?
Keep your emotions in check, Ghulam. Let's at least listen to Tainari's reason for declining. We're here to invite him to the Academia, not to cause a scene.
Sage Kage, I am truly honored that you came here in person, but I'm afraid I must still decline your invitation. I am merely a forest watcher. How could the great minds of the Haravatat have any need of someone like me?
Well, it turns out that your refusal letter had some implications on your master's reputation. He is a renowned sage of the Immorta, after all. So now I've come here in his stead.
I see. Huh. And I figured that given his temper, he would come here and berate me personally.
Tainari, your master is an integral part of this effort, and now he requires your assistance.
And what exactly does my master need of me, Sage Kage?
You'll know once you've arrived in Sumeru City, that is.
And how long will I be required to stay?
There's no definite answer as of now.
Do you mean to tell me that despite coming all the way here to Gundarvaville, you still can't answer the questions I laid out in the letter to my master? If that's the case, then I'm afraid I cannot give you a definite answer either.
Burn!
Tainari, but you...
So be it. Come, Ghulam, we're leaving.
I don't like the way they look at me.
Tainari, what was that all about?
It's nothing. Some people from the Academia wanted me to go to Sumeru City to assist them with a project, but I had to refuse on account of all my responsibilities here. But all that can wait. How did things go with Hypatia?
It was quite the eventful trip, but the main thing is that she's safe and sound. She answered a bunch of questions for us, too.
Very good. Now that the Traveler has made a full recovery, there shouldn't be any reason for you to tarry here longer. I assume you will be heading to Sumeru City, correct?
Not without Kale.
That's right! We want to meet Lesser Lord Kusanali and ask her for advice. Do you have any idea on how we can find her?
Sorry. I'm afraid I don't have any advice for you there.
Well, do you at least know anyone we can try asking in Sumeru City?
Let me think. My trips to Sumeru City have been fairly short, and most of my acquaintances are researchers. How about this? I'll write you a letter of introduction that you can give to a researcher I know. He's from the Immorta Darshan and is adept at gathering information. Asking him might prove worthwhile. Also, when you enter Sumeru City, you'll probably end up receiving something like this item here. I'm not sure if it will ever come in handy for you, but maybe you can give it a try.
Oh? What is it?
It's called an Akasha Terminal. It's a tool produced by the Academia that utilizes the legacy of Greater Lord Ruka Devata. Some say that this very item is the basis of Sumeru's reputation as the City of Wisdom. Needless to say, this device and its usage fall under the Academia's expertise. So I'll leave it to them to show you how to use it.
Great! Next up, Sumeru City! Wait, before that... That's right! Tainari, we have something important to say to Kale before we leave. Is she doing better now?
Yes, she's doing much better. After being confined to her bed all this time, I thought a little walk would do her some good. Last I saw her, she was taking the path towards the North Crossing. She knew you two would be leaving soon, so she must have wanted to see you off.
Thanks, Tainari. All right, let's go!
Farewell. And good luck to you both.
We'll have to grab a drink with Flame when I'm back in the city.
Okay, since this is saying goodbye to Kale, hopefully this is the last fucking time we get screwed.
Never mind. I guess I should just wish you two a safe and successful journey.
For waiting here just to see us off, Kale. We're headed to Sumeru City.
Don't worry about me. I can take care of myself. My condition won't be getting in the way of my duties. I want to be a forest ranger after all. It's up to me and the others to protect the rainforest here. And, I'm sorry. I should have told you both about my condition when we first met. I just wanted you two to treat me as a normal friend. Not some girl that needs your sympathy. But I guess now I understand that the most important thing is for friends to be genuine with one another.
There's no need to apologize, Kale. We should be thanking you for trusting us enough to be your friends and sharing your past with us. We're probably still gonna worry about your condition, but that's because we're friends and we care about you.
Thank you. That means a lot. Before you leave, I have something for you.
Oh? What is it?
It's my recipe for pita pockets. I told you that I'd give you a copy, remember? My handwriting is a little, messy, so please don't laugh.
Yay! Thanks, Kale! Now we can eat those scrumptious little pitas whenever and wherever we like!
I hope that whenever you eat them, you'll both remember your time here in Gandharvaville. Well then, I, Trainee Forest Ranger Kale, bid you both farewell. Please visit Gandharvaville again. The rangers will always be ready to assist you here.
New recipe. I like the food recipes. Okay, so... looks like we can continue this, for which we have 9 hours left on it, apparently. Let me get that thing. Right here. New recipe, a handwritten pita pocket recipe. Small letters, it says. I guess that's how she writes. I like small handwriting. Is there gonna be a chest here? Now I swear to tits.
Just as I expected, the promise of one of my stories has kept you hot on my heels.
But this is just an ordinary tree hollow. Paimon's not seeing any evidence of Aranara.
Use your imagination.
You can deceive the eyes, but you can't deceive the heart. Look with your heart and you too will understand.
Paimon's not sure what look with your heart means, but anyway, let's start by investigating the area around this tree hollow.
I have to pee.